Good morning, all of you. Today, we are going to discuss the poems of our unit number 6 and 7. First of all, we'll discuss the poem number 6, which is Mystery of the Talking Fan. It is a very small poem. Before the poem, we read, is there a ceiling fan in the room where you are sitting now? Is the fan quiet or noisy? If it is noisy, you may be sure it is a distant relative of the talking fan in the poem which you are going to read. So, we sometimes have observed that fan wants to say us something when we are looking to it while sleeping or sitting over our room. So, this is the poem about the fan which chatters a lot, which chattering is a kind of sound which is produced by fan as he want to say something. So we'll discuss this poem. Once there was a talking fan, electrical his chatter, his kind of voice was kind of electrical. I couldn't quite hear what he said. When we observe the fan, we think that he wants to say something, but it is not exactly known. We don't know that what he is going to say now or what he already said. I hope it doesn't matter, because one day somebody oiled his little brilliant motor. So what happened? One day, somebody put some oil in it on his motor of the fan, and all the mystery was spoiled. All the mystery which the writer was creating with the fan, that was spoiled. Because what happened? He ran as well as water, and after the oiling, the fan was running so smooth that it was not making any kind of sound. So that is why poet here says that all the mystery was spoiled. So we have also observed this kind of chatter sometimes in fact. We do feel like that. This poem was written by Morten Robin. Now further, we'll discuss the question answer of the poem. Now, we will discuss the working with the poem. First, fans don't talk, but it is possible to imagine they do. What is it then that sounds like the fans chatter? So, in poem, we have discussed the chattering of the fan. Chattering is the voice which comes out from the fan. So, this question, it is written what their noise is coming from. The noise created by the fan's motor due to lack of oiling was being compared to the fan's chatter. So here poet compares the chattering sound with the fan's motor without oiling. That was the first question. Now second, complete the following lines. First, the chatter is electrical because. So after because, the fan functions on an electrical motor and the attention to my chatter noise was being produced by its motor. Second, it is mysterious because the poet was unable to comprehend what the fan was saying. It was mysterious because the poet doesn't know what the fan was trying to say. Then after we are having third question, what do you think the talking fan was demanding? It was demanding oiling. The moment it was oiled, it fell silent, as we can see in this poem. Next question, how does an electrical fan manage to throw so much air when it is switched on? How the fan is able to throw so much air when it is switched on? switched on. So an electrical fan comprises of three blades and a whirling motor. When switched on, the motor starts rotation, forcing the blades. It generates a lot of pressure, which forces the air downwards in all directions. So this is the process how fan works. Next question and the last one. Is there a talking fan in your house? Create a dialogue between the fan and the machine. So, is there a talking fan in your house? This question is up to you. So, for example, there is a talking fan in my house which perhaps requires some oiling because it chatters with me sometimes and I am also not able to guess what he is saying. But in this question, you can create your own dialogue, 2-3 dialogue with the fans. Now, further we are going to discuss our next poem. So now, we are going to discuss our poem of unit number 7, Dad and the Cat and the Tree. So before we read this poem, have you ever seen a cat climbing a tree? Yes, many times we have seen that. Sometimes a cat may climb too high and get stuck in the tree. Yes, it is possible. The poor thing can't come down without help. How could you help it? Surely not like that in the poem. Is Dad a good climber? What were his plans? Read the poem to find it out. So in this poem, we'll find out what were the plans of the dad and how the cat came down. So we'll start this poem. This morning, a cat got stuck in our tree. Dad said, "Right, just leave it to me." So morning, at the time of morning, the cat got stuck in the tree and Dad said, "Then leave it on me, I will do that work." The tree was wobbly, the tree was tall. Mom said, "For goodness sake, don't fall." So the tree was tall, it was very huge and wavy. Mom said, "For goodness sake, don't fall." So mom is caring for the dad. So that's why she is saying that you don't fall. Fall, soft dad. A climber like me, child's play this is. So the dad is maybe a good climber. That's why he is saying that it is like a child play. It's very easy for me. You wait and see. He got out the ladder from the garden shed. It slipped. He landed in the flower bed. And it got slipped suddenly and the dad landed in the flower bed. "Never mind," said Dad, brushing the dirt off his hair and his face. Brushing the dust, dirt from the hair and the face, and his trousers and his shirts. We'll try plan B. Stand out of the way." Mom said, "Don't fall again, okay?" So then "Fall again," said funny joke. Dad thinks that this is kind of a joke. Then he swung himself upon a branch. It broke. Then he tried to swung himself upon a branch. And it suddenly broke. Dad landed hollow back on the deck. Mom said, "Stop it. Will break your neck." So suddenly mom cried, "Stop it or you will break your neck." Rubbish, said dead. Now we will try plan C. So they move to the plan C now. Easy and ready to a climber like me. Then he climbed up high on the garden wall. Guess what? He didn't fall. So then after he climbed the garden wall and he didn't even fall. He have a great dream and he landed flat in the crook of the tree trunk, right on the cat. The cat gave a yell and sprang to the ground. Please then punch to be safe and sound. So then after the dad landed on the flat in the crook of a tree trunk and the cat sprang to the ground. So cat came down to the ground. So it's smelling and smelling, smug as can be, but poor old dad still stuck up the tree. So and finally the cat landed on the ground, but the dad then also stuck on the tree there. This poem is written by Kit Wright. And now further, we are going to discuss the question answers of this poem. So now we are going to discuss the question answers of the poem. Working with the poem, answer the following questions. First one, why was Dad sure he wouldn't fall? Dad was sure he wouldn't fall because he thought that he was a good climber. In the starting of the poem, he says that. Question 2. Which phrase in the poem expresses Dad's self-confidence best? So the phrase child's play is showing the confidence of the dad, because again and again it is described that he was a good climber and he might have thought that this climbing work is like a child's play for him, means very easy for him. Third, describe plan A and its consequences. Dad got a ladder, he began to climb it, but soon he slipped. He landed in the flower bed. As a result, his hair, his face, trousers and shirt got smudged with dirt, and he removed that. So these were the consequences of the plan A. Then after question 4, plan C was success. What went wrong then? So yes, plan C was success. Dad got stuck in the crook of the tree trunk in the place of the cat. So the thing went wrong here was that the dad got stuck in the tree trunk as the cat, where the cat was stuck, and cat fell on the ground, jumped. Fifth question, the cat was very happy to be on the ground. Pick out the phrase used to express this idea. So, as we can see, so it's smiling and smoking smudge as can be, but over there, that's still stuck up the tree. So, from this line of the poem, we can see that it's smiling and smirking and it is very happy on the ground. Sixth one, describe the cat and dad situation in the beginning and at the end of the poem. So, at the beginning, the cat was stuck in the tree and dad was free. At the end of the poem, the situation got reversed. Dad occupied the place of the cat and the cat was lying free on the ground. It was smiling at dad. Why and when did Dad say each of the following lines? First one, fall. So when mom warned him out not to Second, never mind when he slipped from the ladder and landed in the flower bed. So he said never mind. Third one, funny joke. When mother again warned him, it was funny joke. Fourth one, rubbish. When mother strongly told him to stop his efforts to climb the tree. Now the last question, eighth one. Do you find the poem humorous? Read aloud lines which make you laugh. So yes, the poem is humorous. And you students can write down your favorite lines from the poem in your workbook. Thank you and have a nice day.